What some paleontologists choose to believe seems to defy all logic. Let's take leatherback sea turtles as an example. They say that they remain unchanged since the age of the dinosaurs. Now I have to wonder, if I believed in evolution, and if I believed that the Earth had gone through radical changes over the past 66 plus million years, and if I believed that these epochs of changes were so radical that dinosaurs and other groups of animals, including many ocean creatures, were completely wiped out, and if I believed that most every mammal, from the elephant to the hummingbird, had evolved over that time, well then why would I accept that sea turtles would survive all of that without changing in some way? I mean, 66 million years is a long time, guys. And by the way, sea turtles are not nearly the only survivors that exist in pretty much the same form as their fossil ancestors. I find it much easier to accept that these creatures were designed in the beginning to thrive in specific ecosystems and environments. Now, the icing on the cake of this fabulous story of sea turtle survival and so-called stasis is that today, these animals are threatened, seemingly by man, no less. So we're led to believe that they survived millions of years. We're talking about several mass extinctions, oceans of predators, including mosasaurs, megalodons, only to now be in danger? Now, there's no doubt that their numbers have decreased, and humans have played a role. In some Asian countries, sea turtle eggs, as well as the turtles themselves, are collected for food and medicine, or for their shells, actually. But many times, a turtle will accidentally swim into fishing nets or other gear. They'll get fatally injured. Commercial development on nesting beaches has probably affected them as well. We're not questioning the fact that we need to protect and nurture God's creation. The question is, how did they survive, unchanged, for tens of millions of years, only to be threatened in the last few hundred years? I mean, these leatherback turtles are actually very well designed by the God of the Bible, and they've been swimming in the oceans since creation week. They're massive, they're longer than a tall human, and if we look at the tough shell, which is how the species got its name, it's not like any other turtle. The shell of the leatherback turtle doesn't have any of these hard keratinized scutes, is what they're called. In fact, the shell is actually tough and rubbery, somewhat flexible, and it's lined with 5 longitudinal ridges. So the leatherback can actually dive more than 4 times the depth of other sea turtles, and its special shell helps to do this. The turtle can absorb nitrogen through its flexible shell, and those ridges that you see on the back, well, those aid in hydrodynamics. It makes the dives more energy efficient. So just like we would design a submarine or a yacht so that it was sleek in the water, well, those ridges on the shell also reduce drag while swimming, which is really good because the leatherback sea turtles, well, they swim amazing distances. Many of them migrate across the ocean to nest. And the Western Pacific leatherback feeds off of the western coast of North America, ranging up into the Alaskan waters. But every 2 or 3 years, it journeys across the Pacific to the coasts of Indonesia, Malaysia. It'll go to Papua New Guinea and the Solomon Islands. Now that's an incredible journey, especially for an air-breathing animal. It's the greatest migration by far of any reptile. Now ever since I was 8 years old, I've marveled at the giant leatherback sea turtle, and I see the hand of the Creator in their brilliant design and engineering. I'm David Reeves. Truly, the heavens declare the glory of God.